So now continuing with the Maxwell distribution curve. So continuing with the Maxwell distribution curve, a point is now we see now the area of the curve between d and u versus n du, d and u versus n du versus u. If you plot the curve between d and u versus n du and u, where the here the area under the curve, area under the curve is unity. The area under the curve is unity. Now if we talk about again n d and u versus u. So here area under the curve is total number of particles is total number of particles. Here area under the curve is total number of particles. Now you know area under the curve is constant for the same amount of gas. We know area under the curve, is constant for same amount of gas having same molecular mass at different temperature. Okay, now same amount of gas, amount should be same for same molecular mass and temperature are different. Okay, so let's see this curve. Now, if we draw again different curves, where area under the constant. Okay, now we just let's say we have a curve. Now, if we increase the temperature, the curve shifts like this. Now, further again increase the temperature, the curve shifts like this. But we know that the area under the curve is constant. If we see the area under the curve, now further this will touch to some horizontal this x-axis. So we know area under the curve is constant when the molar mass and molecular weight is constant, and we are varying the temperature. When we are varying the temperature, so here the curve is d n u versus n d u. If we are varying the temperature, here let's say fraction is f1. Now here let's say fraction is f2. Now here let's say the fraction is f3. Now this is ump1, this is ump2, and this is ump3. Okay, this is MP1, MP2, and MP3. Okay, now we need to know where the temperature. If we have increased the temperature, we know then the fraction of the velocity increases. Now, if we see the previous example, then most probable velocity is 2 meter per second. Now, we have increased the temperature, that velocity may increases to 30 meter per second. So, we know UMPS shifts. UMPS increases as temperature increases. Okay, so we know this will be T3, this will be T2, and this will be T1. Now we know T3 is greater than T2 is greater than T1. As the temperature increases, the fraction of molecule increases. And again, we know UMP3 is greater than UMP2 is greater than UMP1. Okay, now we know area under the curve. Area under the curve is 3 equals to area under the curve is 2 equals to area under the curve 1. So all these area constant. Now we know fraction f1 is greater than f2 is greater than f3. Now we know if we have different molecular masses, so m3, m2, m1, m3, m2, m1. So the molecular weight of m3, m2, m1 is m1 is greater than m2 is greater than M3. Okay, so that's how we study the curve. As we increase the temperature, the friction according to increase, how the friction is increasing. Okay, now if we study one more curve. Okay, here it is low velocity range and here it is high velocity range. And here it is a high velocity range. Here it is low velocity range, here high velocity range, it is UMP, most probable speed. Okay, so again the curve is dNu versus NdU. This is the velocity range. So number of particle having very small velocity and very large velocity are lesser than compared to number of particle having. So we know that the if we have the 20 meter per second the velocity, which is UMPS. So the particle having 5 meter per second, or we can say 45 meter per second, will be very less. So the particle having velocity 19 meter per second, or we can say 20 meter per second, having the velocity range near to MPS, will be fraction will be high. Fraction will be high. Now if we say as we increase the temperature, the number of particle having speed will decrease and the number of particle having larger velocity will increase. So as we increase the temperature, the number of particle having lower speed will increase. So as we increase the temperature, this keeps curve shift outside. Okay, this curve bend towards the right side. So the number of particle having lower velocity will decrease and the number of particle having large velocity will increase. So if this curve shifts like this, so this will decrease and this that part will increase. At lower temperature, the distribution of speed near to the most probable speed is narrow, while high temperature, the distribution of speed near to the most probable speed will broad. Okay, so this will become narrow and that will become broad. Okay, as we increase the temperature, number of particle having most probable speed will decrease. So we know number of particle having most probable speed will decrease. So if we again we have different molecular masses, so it is M3, M2, M1. So it is UMP1. It is UMP2. It is UMP3. Okay, now if we increase the temperature, the MP, most probable speed, changes, and we know M1 is greater than M2 is greater than M3. As molecular weight of the gas increases, UMP decreases. So we know as molecular weight of the gas increases, molecular weight of the gas increases, UMP decreases. Because theoretically we see that as we increase the mass of the gas, the speed decreases due to momentum increase. Momentum increase, the velocity decreases. Okay, so and the fraction of the molecule acquire most probable speed will increase. Okay. So now let's see a question. Now if we see two different type of gases, we have a car. This is B gas, this is A gas, and we have given so we have to see the curve. Okay, now given O2 gas at T temperature and S2, O2 gas is there at T temperature and SO2 gas is there at 2T temperature, select the probable curve for the following. So we have given A option, O2 gas is the curve A, B option, SO2 gas is the curve A, C option, O2 and SO2 is at A, and D option it is none. So we know as the temperature increasing and the molecular mass is also doubled, so the both of the gas, both of the curves should be same. So we have given the curve A, so both of the curves should be same as we double the mass. Okay, here mass becomes 2m if it is m, so temperatures also become double. So that's how we will be considering the most probable speed. If we see the formula of most probable speed, V most probable, that is under root over 2 RT by M. under root over 2 RT by m. So this is the temperature and molecular mass. If temperature is double, molecular mass is double, then UMP is same. So the curve will be same. Now let's see one more example. For calculate the ratio, we have to calculate the ratio. A fraction of particle moving from UMP to UMP plus 0.001 at temperature T1 and T2. At temperature T1 and T2. So dNU by NDU. We know the equation 4 pi e raised to the power 4 pi. M divided by 2 pi RT1 raised to the power 3 by 2 multiplied by e raised to the power minus m u square divided by 2 RT1 into u square into now du. Du is, it is u plus du. Now du is 0.001. 0.001 is du. Now we have put in all these value for UMP to UMP plus 0.001. Now again, if you put the value of dNU1 versus dNU2 versus NDU. So now the curve is, now the equation becomes, again we have to put the values 4 pi m by 2 pi RT2 raised to the power 3 by 2 e raised to the power minus mu square divided by 2 RT2, and u square 0.001. again, we know the Maxwell equation, and we are putting the temperature T1 and T2 and the velocity u plus du. Okay, the velocity we know u plus du. Now du is given 0.001 to us, and u is umps. We know the value of umps, that's why it is given. Okay, so now it is, the equation becomes 1 by T1 into T2 raised to the power 3 by 2 e to the power minus mu square divided by 2 RT1 e to the power minus mu square divided by 2 RT2 divided by. Okay, now this is the final equation we get. If we divide in both U1 by U2. Okay, this term get cancelled, and all the constant get cancelled. 4 pi to 4 pi we cancel. Now m to m cancel, these three terms remaining here, and remaining terms are cancelled. Now if you solve this further, it will T2 by T1 raised to the power 3 by 2 under root over T1 divided by T2. That is the value of dNU1 divided by dNU2, the fraction of molecular angular velocity u1 and u2. The ratio becomes t1 by t1 raised to the into 3 by 2, and we have put in the value of u is, if we have put in the value of u 2RT by m, here we have put in the value of u under root 2RT by m, we get this answer. So now if any question is given regarding to the maximum molecular speed, you should know all these constants. Okay, so the constant will generally get cancelled. Okay, because then when the fraction is asked, the variable is molecular mass, temperature and velocity. Okay, these three variables we have, rest of them, if you see, they are constants. Okay, so if the velocity range is given u plus du, then you have to put the value of du.